up, guys? I just want to give you this real quick gist before night will come. I have to run away from my house because, man, there's so much noise inside. There's really no place to sit down and chill and have better gist. Okay. So, like, you guys have heard about this whole surviving Peruzzi stuff, right? You've heard about it. In case you don't know the gist, some music producer called Golden Boy Entertainment has revealed that he signed Peruzzi, who is actually supposed to be a member of Davido Music Worldwide, which is Davido's label. So this guy has claimed that he signed Peruzzi, and in fact, most of Davido's hit songs belong to his label, like Fear, Risky, Assurance, that Peruzzi had those songs while he was under his label or something like that. I'm sure you've seen most of the receipts, which he shared on Twitter.
Damn, fresh. Shorty want $1 million, so make a wire. Turn me to undercover, my girl. Aye, she say all her friends are living la vida loca. I deform you, me, my lover.
Right now, what it means is that Davido and Peruzzi owes this young man some money. You know, they owe him some money. Or what should have happened, or the right way it should have been done, is that this guy should have been signed under Davido Music Worldwide as an imprint label. You know, a story for another day though. But I just want to make something clear, that the reason why this whole record label artist situation is so rampant in Nigeria is because our legal system is very weak. G Worldwide is presently in court with Kiss Daniel, you know. And from the time of Brymo and Chocolate City, it's just been like that. Nigerian artists has the audacity to walk away from their Nigerian contracts. They have the audacity to walk away from, they've been paid to go and perform, but they will not show up. Last year in 2018, Kiss Daniel was paid to go and perform in Igbenedion University, or I mean Babcock. He was paid $3 million, according to Punch newspapers, but he didn't turn up. Why? Because according to him, they did not arrange for 2 G-Wagons to take him to the venue. Can you imagine that? You know? So, but if it's a proper show that is happening in the US or like Coachella, he can't do it. I can tell you as we speak, Davido and Kiss Daniel, they are signed to Sony Music, but they dare not breach that contract. They dare not breach one letter in that contract. They will not breach it. But with their Nigerian labels, they are very quick to mess around and they are quite very quick to work, because you know our laws are weak. We know that justice is not served, especially when you have some money and you have some power. Our legal system is weak. That speaks volumes about our legal system. Another thing I need to emphasize is that this kind of attitude shows that you don't have integrity. You have zero integrity. If you sign a record deal, you have to keep to your end of the deal. You know, you knew what you were doing when you went into the contract, but you were desperate. Then at the point when you think now, okay, you have blown, you now want to renegotiate your deal. I mean, it's okay to renegotiate your deal after a couple of years, but you keep renegotiating, just like Kiss Daniel. Kiss Daniel renegotiated his deal according to court documents. He tried to renegotiate his deal several times until he now brought a team of lawyers who found a loophole for him to escape his deal with G Worldwide, and that's how he walked away from his deal. So in Nigeria, we're just playing legal fireworks. You know, there's really no serious law going on. We lack integrity. Most of our celebrities lack, at least if you can walk away from a record deal, you lack integrity. There's really no difference between you and a politician who goes into power and then after a while you start stealing. There's no difference between you and a politician that loots money. It's same lack of integrity, okay? Another point I want to make is that all this idea of demonizing the record label and making the record label look bad, insulting the record label, calling them desperate. You see people, they'll say, oh, G Worldwide should go and find another artist. G Worldwide should move on. You know, they should go and, you know, G Worldwide has some other artists that are not doing very well, like DJ Shabzi, I think. You know, they say, G Worldwide, they should move on. Without Kiss Daniel, will people die? Go out and find another, move on. We are so quick to tell everybody to move on. If you go to the market to buy tomatoes and you take the woman's tomato and run away, will the woman move on? They will chase you and beat you up until they get their money from you. You cannot cheat someone and tell the person to move on. It doesn't make any sense, okay? It was a contract. You signed a contract. The record label invested in the artist. The record label took a risk, not knowing whether or not this artist is going to blow. What if the artist did not blow? What if the artist did not blow? Okay, so now you've blown. You've walked away from your deal. At the moment you sign the deal, you have become a product. And the purpose of that deal is to make profit. But at the time, when the record label now wants to make profit, everyone will be like, ah, they are cheating. Ah, this record label, slave deals. Oh, it was not a slave deal when you were desperate, Abby. It was not a slave deal when you needed airtime, when you needed radio play. But now you don't blow. It has become a slave deal. Everyone on the shout, slave deal. Calm down. You are a product and the objective is to make money off you. So calm down and fulfill your end of the deal, okay? Can we all stop this thing about demonizing the record labels and making them look bad? Anyway, that is my take in the whole matter. I mean, some record labels do sign slave deals, but I think we should all be guided. We should keep contracts. Nigeria go better one day, sha. But that's my whole take. What do you think? Tell me your comments in the, type. Say something. All right? Join the family. My name is Chizoba Adeola, and this is What is Hot Nigeria. So basically, my objective is just to, Nigerian gist, economic conversations, social conversations, entertainment, politics. Tell me what you want me to talk about, okay? And we are going to get right into it. But for now, I have to go. See you next week. Subscribe, like, and share. And don't forget, my name is Chizoba Adeola. I'll see you again next week. Bye.